So welcome to the training program, the masterclass on business data analytics using Power BI. So in this particular module, we are going to discuss about the most important, all the sections are important definitely, but this is the phase where you are actually getting into the preparation mode. Saying that, okay, now I know how to connect to the data sources. What are the data sources? We have seen all these things. Now we are planning towards preparing the data, doing the mining of this and cleansing of the data, actually. So for this purpose, we need to understand, first of all, because when we are saying that we need to cleanse the data, we need to also look into some of the factors, including data types and all these components over here. So let's have a look. So this module is divided into three parts actually. So the first part, we will talk about the null value data quality issues that might come and how do we mitigate them, and how do we go about user-friendly value replacements. I mean, suppose if you have some columns wherein we have, let's say, some data that we need to replace values with. So that we will be learning in this particular part of the module, which is module number 4. In part 2, we are going to identify the concepts of how do we join the data. I mean, if you have multiple data sources, or let's say if you have data pointers which has got many tables and something, how do we join that? And then we will quickly have an understanding about the data types that Power BI gives you, and how does these data types are utilized to perform the table structures and other things, right? We have two back-to-back activities in this particular module. So the one that we will be talking about, marketing data. So marketing data, majorly talking about how marketing data can be used to perform data analytics. Very easy, very simple flat file we will be considering. And with the flat file, we will be talking about how different KPIs and other things can be created using a flat file also. We will then move on to the advanced level, wherein we'll be seeing that, okay, what are the naming conventions that we should be keeping in mind when we are getting into a mode wherein we are working with multiple tables over here. So this is the first time that we are going to utilize the cloud-based ERP system. Whatever we have seen in the last module where we connected to the SQL server. So what we are going to do is, in this module, we are going to actually work on the cloud part of it. And we will connect it through an OData service, and then we will bring it to our environment. So we will see how these all things. So preparation of the entire, database, data structure in Power BI. That's what we are going to see in this particular module. So first thing first, we are going to see that, okay, if we get some data and if we have some issues with the null values and let's say some data quality, so how do we resolve those inconsistencies in the data? So definitely for this purpose, we need to take care of, we have to showcase some data sets, and then only we will be able to give you the right approach or answers to this. We will be taking up multiple data sources. So we have multiple data sources over here. We have some call center data. We have finance related data. We have human capital data. So human capital data we will be using for the capstone projects. And we have several general data sets as well. Data sets that we have got. So out of this is the marketing data that we are looking forward to. So back to back, what we will do is, first of all, we will continue with the attrition data that we saw in our last module. So we will again connect back to the marketing data, and we'll see how do we do some kind of small analysis from there. We will then move on to the marketing data. So this is how the marketing data looks like. So kind of a small data set, but it has got around 45,000 records. So we'll see how to, use data cleansing techniques to, clean up this particular data. We will see that also. And we do have other data sources like some census data, projects data, supplies data, consumer price index data. We have got common matrices that are there from the HR perspective. So all these different data types are there. And we do have a data which is like a trial balance data. We will start off with this particular data. First of all, we'll see how to cleanse this kind of data. This is an Excel data. So we understand where is the problem with this particular data. So you see that, first of all, the data looks like that it is in a pivotal format. Somebody has created a pivot out of some data and then given it to us as an Excel file. And we have to work on that particular data. So the first thing that we might have to do is to see that how do we remove data out of this pivot into a tabular format. Only then we will be able to utilize this particular file. So that's what we are going to see in the first place. So let's quickly move on to Power BI. So this is a typical finance data, we can say trial balance data. So in the history of Power BI, there has been many such instances and cases wherein we first of all ingest the data and then find that there are some challenges, because every time we cannot predict that okay, what is going to come and how we are going to utilize our predictive understanding of the data and do this kind of analysis. So that's why we say that only a prepared mind can see opportunities, right? So we implement those preparedness over here. And during this particular session, during this a part of this particular training program, we have gotten USP for you as well, that at the end of this program we have capstone projects, and at the end of those capstone projects and assignment and everything, what we are going to do is we are going to give you an extensive module and a session on handling the various questions that can come up during the interview sessions, or let's say during any meeting, or let's say any kind of interactions or communications that you are doing related to data analysis. So it's not that only giving you the technical side of it, but also giving you the communication part and empowering you with those communication capabilities actually. So these all things will be a part of this entire training module and program itself. So we have the data. So first of all, we will be working with the attrition data. Once again, we will get this attrition data, and end to end, we will see how to do the cleansing part of it actually. So we go to this and we go to CSV file, and with CSV file, we will be going to the, okay, sorry. So the first exercise that we are going to do, or the demo that we are going to do, the cleansing part was, it would be the trial balance that we wanted. So yeah, sorry. So we see that we have the, okay, let me just see. It is trialbalance.xlsx. So which means that we should be directly hovering across the Excel file. General, and we have the trial balance, and we say open. So it opens the file, and it's an Excel file, so it will directly take me to this data, And what we do is we see that there are some problems in this particular data. Because we are talking about the preparedness of the data, that's why we are here. And we'll see what are the null value treatments and all these things. We can do it over here. Inconsistency, if you see in the data, how do we mitigate that? So first of all, we will try it with this trial balance data. Then we will go to the attrition data. And then finally, we will go to the marketing data. So back to back, we will be working with three different demos, three different types of files. And again, let me repeat, we have to go step by step. Right, so don't miss out on any parts, and then make sure that you have your pen and paper ready when we are now going deeper into Power BI. So lots and lots of things. It's a huge program, and it gives you end to end understanding about like how do we work with this particular tool and how do we actually use this tool for advanced level of analysis. Right, so that's the journey that we are taking. So we see there are some problems. So how do we approach these things? So first of all, when we just use the navigator, so we saw that, okay, this data is coming up as a preview and we see there are some challenges. So we definitely won't go for load. We will go for the transform of the data. So transforming data. And it brings us to this particular place. Now, here when we move, so what happens is that we see that the data has come, but with all the anomalies that we saw in the actual Excel file as well. So we saw this particular file's details. So we can now close this because we are already in Power BI. So we'll see what are the things that Power BI has done. The first thing is it has taken this source, navigated through the data, automatically did some promotion of headers. These are the things that it does, and then did a change the data type actually. Now, this is a different type of issue that we see. So the first two rows are actually the rows which need to be omitted. And then the third row is supposed to be the first row or the header row out here, right? So let's see. How do we manage this thing over here? So the first task, we need to remove the first two rows. So we have options over here to remove columns, remove rows, and all these things are here. So what we do is we go to this option called remove rows, and we say that, okay, we need to remove some rows. And these rows are either you can remove it from bottom, or you can remove from alternate rows, but we are saying that we need to remove the top rows. How many rows have got problem? The top two rows has got this problem. So what we do is we go to home menu of Power Query Editor, and there we will see there's an option called remove rows, and there we click on this option called remove top rows. It is asking how many rows. We simply say two rows from the top, and then you say okay, and automatically the two rows are removed. Till now, what you see is that the data, the headers are not in place. So now the company name is coming as one of the headers, which should not be the case. So what we need to do is now we will be going again to the home tab, and under home menu you see this option which says use first row as headers. So we go to use first row as headers, and automatically it gives me this particular data. Now, certain inconsistency we see over here. The first inconsistency is that my data, though it has got all the labels, so you can see over here, it has identified that, okay, account, which is a text format data. And then it has identified the description also. So most of the accounts, or let's say account activities that we do, they have this column in common actually. The major inconsistency that we see is from this particular column, wherein it is showing the date as the header. So it has the date, and then we have the header over here. And then also you will see that, okay, this is April, this is April of 2014, and then we have 2019. And then we see that there are some additional columns that has come over here. So we are not sure about how, because when we look at the data, there were no as such issues. But when we bring it to Power BI, we are seeing these issues. So the first task that we are going to do is these null values needs to be removed actually. So we press the shift key, we select all the columns which has got null, 100% empty. So we right click and we say remove these columns. Usually what happens is that if you have got bigger number of columns which needs to be removed, then we can select the columns which needs to be kept as in the data model, and then we remove the rest kind of thing. Now what we do is we see that the data, I mean it looks absolutely fine, and from the April to March we have got this data, and it has identified that all of these columns are in floating point numbers, decimal numbers actually, and it is showcasing this data absolutely fine. The next thing that we need to do is we told that our data is in the format of pivot. It looks like a pivot. So the next task that we need to do in terms of cleansing this particular data would be to remove it from the pivot architecture. So let's see how do we remove it from pivot architecture. So what we need to do, it's a one-step process. So to just go to the transformation, this is a transformation technique that we are heading towards. So we go to the transform option, and then we see there is an option which says transpose. So we need to transpose this data. We say transpose, but the moment we say transpose, what happens is not everything that we wanted gets transposed. So I mean somewhere it created a problem of the transpose table. So we have to remember that what we need to transpose. So right now what happened is the last column was highlighted, so it transposed based on the last column. What we need to do is we need to say that the first two columns need not be touched. The first two columns needs to be intact, and then what we do is we go for the rest of the columns. So that's how it works out. So we have these two columns in place, and then what we do is we say we need to, I mean there is no concept of transpose over here. So there are two methods. I mean one is you say transpose, but in that case transpose needs to be, I mean can only be done when you have a set number of data points. Here what is happening is you have data in columnar ways. You need to convert it as an unpivoted data. So the pivot format is there. We need to say unpivot. So what we need to do is we go to unpivot option, and here we will see there are three options over here: unpivot, unpivot other columns, and unpivot only selected columns. So in case you have not selected anything, it will unpivot everything, right? But we need to understand what to unpivot and what to not. So all the dimension, the attribute data, the main data points, the main data set, we need to actually keep them intact. And then what you need to do is we need to unpivot rest of the columns. So what we need to do, we need to say unpivot, and we say unpivot other columns. The moment we say unpivot other columns, what happens is it unpivots, I mean it doesn't touch the description and the account. And what it does, it actually moves all the records one below another. So we have all the records and data over here. Now finally, after doing this, what happens is it actually puts up two columns. So the first column says attribute and the second column says value. So value and attribute, these are the two things that it is giving us. So what we need to do is we need to get rid of these columns that we see. So we say that this is not attribute, this is actually month, and I mean month and the year. So we can call it as date. And then this is actually the amount. So it will now look like a typical bank statement kind of thing, right? So you can see it. Now there is an issue that we need to mitigate. The issue is that everything that we see, if you just click on the date, you will see that everything is in 2019-20, but one is in 2014. So what we do is, first of all, we have multiple ways of doing it. First of all, we can convert this, or what we can do is, still it is in the ABC format. ABC means it is in still in the text format. So what we can do is, we will be first of all converting this and changing this to 014. So see how it works. So we can simply right click on this, and we can say, so now it is in text format, right? Now, so you can see it is in text format, and we say replace values. So we simply say 430. So I say everything should be fine. Just change it to 2019. So it just changed it to 2019, because that was an error. That was an error that we identified. Now what we need to do is, so these all things we need to do it. I mean, we need to check these all things manually. This is the task of the cleanup process that we call it, right? Now that we know that this is a date, so what we will do is, we will convert this into a date format, not date time. We will convert it into a date format, and instantly you see that it converts. Now when you look at this particular figure, so it is in proper format. So we have got the date and the amount and the description and the account. So all these things are in line, and you can see the amounts are also coming in a proper format only. So now this brings us to the format types also, that how data types are working. So we will see it in our next section, next part. But for the time being, what we will do is, this is the balance sheet data. So we will be saying close and apply. We will go through the transformations one by one before we close this particular part. So this was a very important section. We save this. Module 4, and this is part 1, and this is trial balance data preparation PBIX. Trial balance data preparation PBIX we just created, and then we can see that the data sources are here. And something very interesting, you will see that whenever there is a date, you will find that there is a concept of hierarchy. So year, quarter, month, day, all these things you will be seeing one by one if it is a date format, right? Now this data can be seen very easily from the second tab, which is your format over here. Now if it is a trial balance, so we know that, okay, a trial balance has a very unique feature. So it will, the amount will be always zero, whatever the things are, right? So I just wanted to now test it. I mean, because we are preparing the data, only then analysis can be done. So what we will do is, we will simply test this particular data. So we will bring a simple, we will talk about visualizations in later stage, but right now we are just bringing the account and the amount. So we bring the account and we bring the amount. So you can see this is how the chart would look like. And to know that whether it is accurately done or not, what you can do is, you can bring in the amount over here and then take it as a card, and you will see that the amount points to 0.00, and the chart also signifies the same thing. So we have got positives and negatives, so debit and credit side, both the things, and it shows zero, which means the financial transactions are posted absolutely in a good way, and all these things are fine. So let's do a small recap of what we did in this particular part. So first of all, what we did is we went to the data source. We had a look at the trial balance data, and we understood where is the challenge with that particular data. And we saw that the data is actually, in a pivoted format. So what we did during this particular section is that we unpivoted the data. We understood the columns, what are the columns. We removed the null values. We replaced the values. We understood how to replace the value also. And we removed some of the rows which are not required. So all these activities we did. And finally, what we did is like we progressed with the concept of unpivoting the data, which is very much required. And then we got into the canvas area. And then what we did is we checked all the data types are fine or not. And then we converted, since we have converted it into a date, and that's why the hierarchy is coming: year, quarter, month and day. So that's actually what we have achieved in this particular part. So the data preparation, so let me just, this one we can just call it as trial balance prep or something like this, trial balance prep. So data preparation has a long history, and whenever we are talking about data, the first thing that should come in your mind is that how do we cleanse the data, make it usable from the perspective of data analysis. So that's what from module 4 part 1. So let's move to the next section wherein we will be working with the other types of data over here.